please welcome from Hospital for Special Surgery Chief Digital and Technology Officer, Ashish Barad.
Hello, everybody. So I am Dr. Ashish Barad. I'm a practicing physician for roughly 20 years now. You know, with that being said, the work we're doing with Palantir is really exceptional. I can't wait to dive in from that perspective. There's an interesting fact that I want to open with that you may not know. So since I started practice, roughly 20 years ago now, physician productivity has dropped roughly 13%. So just think about that for a second. Nursing, even more significant, right? So I did a time study recently. Our nurses spend roughly 20% of their shift with their patients. That's a lot of hours, a lot of time on paperwork, administrative tasks. So we are taking that on, and I want to make a very significant portion of that is after we digitized everything in healthcare. So although there's still faxes do exist in healthcare, we have digitized everything, and yet productivity has dropped 13%. So our partnership with Palantir is really focused on giving that time back so our front lines can spend time with their patients, which is what they went to nursing medical school to do. So before we dive in, I do want to make sure that many of you may not know what HSS stands for. It's the Hospital for Special Surgery. We're in New York, and it really is the premier destination for musculoskeletal health, right? And you can read the stats. We have many of them. We're very proud of them. But I'll leave you with this, just as far as the hospital goes. During the NBA playoffs, when your Achilles tendons pop, you come to HSS. So it is absolutely the place to be. So you know, I'm going to dive into a demo to show you something different that we're doing now. And I know you heard a lot about appeals with Maine Health, so I won't spend as much time on this slide. But I do want to say that at the beginning of this year, we partnered with Palantir, and we decided to take on that same journey of automating insurance appeals. And as a physician, appeals, authorizations, insurance is the bane of your existence oftentimes. And we really took that on end to end. And what we found was 45 minutes of manual work by a lot of people, really just doing chart searching and typing letters and taking on the insurance companies, went down to 5 minutes. And we did that work in 5 weeks. We've been tackling that for decades. So in a simple 5-week time frame, we were able to automate all those. And what we could get to about 100 appeals per month to insurance companies turned to 1,000 appeals a month. And so it wasn't, and so the efficiency was tremendous. But I also want to make sure that we don't just focus on efficiency. The performance of the AI was better than the people that were doing it. So and that time for those people was given back to higher license work. It was a big win for us. It appeals, you heard a lot about it a bit ago, so I won't spend too much time on it. But I do want to make sure you understand that roughly 1 in 10 appeals claims in healthcare claims is denied by insurance companies. So we spend a lot of our time and energy of manual labor, our nurses, our doctors, our staff, on really working that through. And so if you really think about the fact that 17% of healthcare or 17% of the GDP is on healthcare, a lot of that has to do with this, what's called waste in medicine. This is an example of that waste. It's really not in any way helping a patient, a person get care. It's really just doing a lot of manual labor and work, paperwork. So to automate that is very significant for people getting care. That's work that we've already undertaken, we continue to do, and is really significant. We expect a lot more things. So, you know, having that win under our belt, we said, you know, that's wonderful, and we've automated a lot of the back end. But we haven't really touched the patient. And that's the center of care. That has drifted a bit in healthcare. We spend so much time on the paperwork. We spend so much time on the administrative work. We're not spending as much time with the patient as I just articulated at the beginning of this. So how do we get that time back? How do we really get the patient back in to the center of the care? The medical record that we've had in healthcare isn't really focused on the patient as they go through a journey. It's very siloed. And so when you show up to a clinic, you go to the hospital, you get a phone call, you may go to different specialists, you might go to an imaging center. All that data is not following really you along in a very, you know, continuous way where the care teams are really reading off of one sheet of music. So that's the work we're taking on with Palantir now. So we started 4 weeks ago. Really all that fragmentation of care, at best, it's a poor experience. At worst, it's critical details that get missed, right? It leads to poor outcomes. So we're building a patient card, is what we're calling it, right? So really just a single sheet of music. It's a single living summary that travels with the person as they go through their journey. Allergies, medications, care plans, what's next, predictive. And it's consistent everywhere. So now you have clinicians, all clinicians, surgeons, doctors, nurses, medical assistants, patients, very important, and payers, right? They are part of your healthcare journey, all reading off the same page. And that is not possible in today's world. That data lives in different places. So it's living, as I said. So the card updates, right, with real time, in real time, so orders, results, and decisions change. So I think at the beginning of this, you heard from American Airlines, and in many ways I think of running an OR, and I've done that before in my past life, is like American Airlines, right? We have crews, we have turnarounds, we have clearances, we have equipment, and the occasional emergency, right? The difference, we actually encourage sharp objects. So in this case, we're seeing a patient that's not ready for surgery, as she needs a lifestyle medicine referral, right? So you see that the ontology puts a flag there. Take a minute, because, right, if you just watched this demo, you might not really capture what's happening. Take a minute, think about Zoe. She's your mom, she's your spouse, she's your sister. She's been hurting for years. She needs a knee replacement. She lives in pain every day. She finally got to the best place on earth to get her knee done, and the surgeon said, you need surgery. Can't wait to be pain-free, right? Now, let's dive back into the demo, right? Because that person is waiting and can't wait to live pain-free. And so you see AIP running. It raises a flag. There's a risk. So in seconds, right, it's assembling the relevant data, BMI, tobacco use, meds, problem list. It checks payer policy, clinical criteria for medical necessity. So what you see now is because she's not yet cleared, AIP is automatically compiling and submitting. The agent is submitting as well the prior authorization packet with the right documentation, and it's alerting the whole care team in real time with a clear reason code and next steps. So what you see is that she needs counseling for smoking cessation and for weight, right? Management. And so that is a criteria that is both needed by the insurance company and the right thing to do for Zoe to ensure that she gets that in check before she has surgery. Current state, that is all data that lives in different parts of the chart, if at all, right? And that is something that really, if it gets picked up, great. Oftentimes it doesn't get picked up, right? And either, again, at best, you don't get paid for the surgery you're doing, and at worst, at least the bad outcomes, because that's actually the right thing to do for the patient. So here, you see that she's moved through this process, and Zoe has moved into pre-surgical screening. Her cardiac clearance is in, and the living patient card stays current across the teams. The information that's being put in there, the whole team's seeing it. And really what's transformative about this agent that you're seeing as far as next steps here is in a few clicks, right, it's recommending same-day discharge. So now that she's had lifestyle medicine, she actually qualifies for same-day discharge. She can go back to her own bed. She can sleep, and she can have her caregivers there. Doesn't need to stay in the hospital, right? It's notifying the whole teams. That has a huge, just like an airline industry, let's say, has a huge implication on the surgeon needs to know, the nurses need to know, the clinicians, the operators need to know, insurance may need to know. So again, single pane of glass. It's messaging, Zoe, patient in the loop, right? That is right now potentially a nurse's job to remember to call Zoe and say, hey, you actually qualify for same-day discharge. We're going to move up your surgery to be able to do that. And that's a manual thing. And it takes time away, again, from that 20% of time in the patient's room. And we have a second customer in healthcare, our physicians, right? So and making sure the surgeons, in this case, are aware of this move and this recommendation. And with consent, offers to move the surgery time. So it's one source of truth, coordinated actions, and zero swivel chair.
Hi, this is an automated call from the HSS call center. Can you please confirm your full name and date of birth?
Hi, my name is Zoe McMillan, and I was born July 27th, 1961.
Hello, Ms. McMillan. This is HSS Scheduling calling from HSS. I'm calling to inform you of a change to your upcoming surgery schedule.
So we're not going to play the whole recording for the sake of time, but it's have that conversational AI to be able to guide, having that source of truth to be able to guide that conversation and to recommend same-day discharge. And if you listen to the recording, which would say, well, I can't do 11, can I do 9, right? It's able to accommodate that knowing the surgery schedule. So really, really getting the patient back in the loop and being able to have that shared decision-making with patients that has oftentimes been missing. So again, this is where we started with the schedule, with the red flag. And this is where we land, right? No red flags, schedule optimized, not just for the patient, but the clinicians, the surgeons, the OR techs. So no red flags, everyone in the loop. Again, we stood this up in 4 weeks. So as far as speed to action, we're just getting started on our journey. We're taking the entire patient journey, right? From discovery, ouch, to recovery, right? And we're gonna use AI to orchestrate that. Very important. We're not taking our frontline clinicians, our doctors or nurses out of the loop. We're actually elevating and augmenting them to do what's necessary that humans should do with humans. AI is a really wonderful orchestrator. Things get lost in the middle. Right? And so that's how we look at it. So our goal is simple, right? We want our people with our patients in their care journey, and we want the agents to do everything else. Thank you.